कृष्णे नमः। नमः ओम विष्णुपादाय कृष्णप्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदांत स्वामिन इति नामिने। नमस्ते सरस्वते देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात देश तारिणे वांछाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपा सिंधुभ्य एव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्त वृंद। हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्ण। So we have reached the third chapter of Bhagavad Gita. We are somewhere in middle. We have another half a way to go, and we'll be doing this journey together. That's the best part. So far we have seen that Arjuna, after hearing the second chapter of Bhagavad Gita, instead of feeling very happy, oh chalo Bhagwan Shri Krishna, thank you so much, you have answered all my doubts, he became more confused. Yes, whether should I take to the process of knowledge, or should I do something tangible and practical in this world? That is when Krishna introduces the concept of karma. In karma, he talks about two things. He talks about karma kanda and he talks about karma yoga. Karma kanda is offering sacrifices in alliance, in accordance to demigods. And doing karma yoga is to use and engage your propensities to work in this world as per the Vedas. So last time we had seen the section that unless and until a person follows the Vedas, he doesn't follow the scripture, a person is sinful. Yes? So we saw the till here. So now we have to go to the next verse, which is the third chapter, verse number 17. So please follow along. So I'd given a very apt title to this section, the discussion that we are going to do today. There's a reason for this. When a saintly person goes out, we are often given we get a lot of respect. That's one thing. Many people, they come, aap to sadhu mahatma hai. And of course, if some people attempt to touch the feet, we don't allow them. Some people give donations. Some people say, aapke paas kanthi tulsi mala hai kya? हमें जनवा लेनी है, वी वॉन्ट टू टेक द सीक्रेट थ्रेड फ्रॉम यू। मेनी गुड इंसिडेंसेस, मेनी लाइक दिस, आई कैन काउंट, कीप काउंटिंग। एट द सेम टाइम वी फेस चैलेंजेस ऑल्सो। सो आई रिमेंबर आई गॉन टू अ पर्टिकुलर कॉलेज, MIT Kothrud, मेनी ऑफ यू विल बी नोइंग, इट्स क्वाइट फेमस। एंड MIT Kothrud, आई एक्सपीरियंस्ड बोथ, आई एक्सपीरियंस्ड ऑनर एंड डिसऑनर, आई विल एक्सप्लेन हाउ। So first time I had gone directly to the, I wanted to meet the director of the college. And the director of the college left his cabin along with all the deans. He came personally to welcome me at the gate, brought me in and made me sit on his seat. This was the honor that we received. And as we were leaving the college, that time the security guard came and asked, "Aaj fancy dress competition hai kya?" "Is today fancy dress competition? You won very nice attire. Aap log jeetega." I told him we won the first place. Isliye first place jeete, isliye director se jaake milke aaye. We met the director of the college. He called us to felicitate. Said we turned the joke around. So we experience everything. So one of the things that people usually ask is, आप साधु लोग, साधु ऐसे क्यों बनते हो? Why do you be like this? Why we see that you are still young, hale and healthy? Why don't you work? काम धंधा क्यों नहीं करते आप लोग? सिर्फ भजन करते रहते हैं. So some sort of such questions are going to be answered in this section. So very interesting one, right? We'll go ahead. The shloka number 17. यस्तु आत्मरतिरेव स्यात् आत्मतृप्तश्च मानवः आत्मन्येव सन्तुष्टः तस्य कार्यम न विद्यते. सो प्रीवियस सेक्शन व्हाट डिड कृष्णा से? लॉर्ड कृष्णा क्लियरली टोल्ड दैट एवरीबॉडी इन दिस वर्ल्ड हैज सम वर्क टू डू. बराबर, दिस व्हाट ही सेड. एज सून एज समबडी इज एन एम्बॉडीड बीइंग, देयर इज अ सोल इन दिस पर्टिकुलर बॉडी, यू हैव दिस मटेरियल बॉडी, यू हैव द सटल बॉडी, दैट्स ऑल्सो मटेरियल बॉडी, gross body, subtle body, then you have a prescribed duty in this world. But now he is going to speak something different. You see, it'll be reconciled. Parshuram Prabhu is there? Yes. Yes, Prabhu.
But for one who takes pleasure in the self, whose human life is one of self-realization, and who is satisfied in the self only, fully satiated, for him there is no duty.
So what we understand from this section is there are certain people who need not work. Aise bhi log hai, there are exceptions. Aise nahi ki everybody has to get into the system of work. From this loka we understand that there is a section of people who need not work. Who are those people? They are the ones who are taking to the path of pure self-realization. The only sense self-realization is their goal. The path that they're doing is only self-realization. Now we can translate this self-realization very easily as Krishna consciousness. Later on, Krishna will clarify that self-realization and God realization, they both go parallelly. One cannot have self-realization without including God, because nowadays this is a new concept. One of my students, because now what has happened is the colleges have all started online. So one of the students, his teacher was telling him, and he was telling me that in the lockdown time, the teacher started taking interest in yoga. And I really don't know from where she got this concept that madam was telling that yoga was started by Buddha. Yoga was started by Buddha, as though yoga did not exist before that. And number two, yoga has nothing got to do with God. Oh my God, the book that speaks about yoga is Bhagavad Gita, spoken by God himself. How can somebody say yoga has got nothing to do with God? But this is a very, very famous concept which is arising. Spirituality without God. Yoga without God. So this is what is happening in the society. People are somehow or the other trying to take out God from the picture. This is called typically the Ashwatthama mentality. You know what is Ashwatthama mentality? I'll tell you a story. Once what had happened, Ashwatthama approached Krishna. We all know who is Ashwatthama, a very famous character in the Mahabharata. So he came to Krishna and he said, Krishna, I wanted your Sudarshan Chakra. Krishna said, well, I can give it, but will you be able to catch it? Was a koi problem nahi. Main kar lunga. I'll do it. Give me. So Krishna said, okay, fine. Catch it if you can. And he tried to hand him over the Sudarshan Chakra. Ashwatthama, with all his Astra Vidya, Mantra Vidya, he tried to capture Sudarshan like this. All he tried, all permutation, combination. But he could not do it. He said, Krishna, jane do. Rehne do, koi baat, I'll go. And as he was leaving, Lord Krishna asked him, wait a minute. Ashwatthama, please tell me, why did you want the Sudarshan Chakra? He said, Sudarshan Chakra na, aapko maarne ke liye. I wanted to kill you. So he wanted to use Krishna's Sudarshan Chakra to kill Krishna. This is called Ashwatthama mentality. So people today are using scriptures, using Vedas, using statements of Bhagavad Gita to disprove the existence of God or to remove Krishna out of the picture. That is a typical mentality. People want Ram Rajya today. Ram Rajya hota to kitna acha, but without Ram. How is that possible? Prahrishtam muditam loke tushto pushto sudharmika niramayohi nirrogo durbiksha bhavya varjita. The Ramayana says this is the quality of Rama Rajya. I'll elaborate some other time. But the point here is Rama Rajya is possible only by keeping Lord Ram in the center. Correct? So similarly, self-realization is possible only by putting God in the center. That is the beginning of self-realization. And for such people who want to exclusively have, like, everybody to be self-realized should put God in the center. But there are certain people, the self-realized souls, who have only God in the picture. Correct? And these people need not work. This is a statement directly by Krishna. Let's go to the next statement. The next verse.
नैव तस्य कृते नार्थो न कृते नेह कश्चन न चास्य सर्वभूतेषु कश्चिदर्तव्यपाश्रयः.
A self-realized man has no purpose to fulfill in the discharge of his prescribed duties, nor has he any reasons not to perform such work, nor has he any need to depend on any other living being.
There are three parts. I'll explain part one by one. The first part is, he has no purpose to fulfill. I'll tell you. Everybody who goes to a company, an employee, he has some project, right? The company gives you a project. And along with project comes one more thing. What is that? Deadline. Is date ke andar project khatam karna hai, deadline. Now let me ask you a question. What will a person do if he has completed his project much before the deadline? Deadline is 3 mahine ka kaam. You have 3 more months to go. And imagine 1 month he finishes. He finishes his work in 1 month. Ek mahine mein kaam ho gaya. What will he do? Any guesses? Let's see. There are many of them typing. Please do type in the chat what you would do. Yes, this is precisely Ranchan Sharan Pro is really smart. He's saying, may not tell manager and chill out. Yes, that's good. He will not tell the manager, because you tell the manager, you will get another project. This is what Amit wants. Amit Kalia ji, you seem to be a workaholic person. He's saying, get a new project. Okay, but ideally, yes, okay, you will get appreciation from boss, that is true, but the appreciation comes with bigger work. He knows your capacity now. Achha, ye 3 mahine ka kaam, 1 mahine mein kar deta, efficiency is too high. Now let us squeeze him out. Yes, Anshu Goel Prabhu is very smart, saying you'll get more work if you tell. So what you should do is, yes, we can do other things. We can pursue our fringe fields, side activities, and a person will be kind of relaxed. Others all will be slogging. Aray, project khatam karna hai, we have to do this. Yeah, so he will enjoy not the whole rest of the time, but he'll submit 1 week. 1 week or maybe 4 days to go, that time he'll go and submit his work. And then he's ready to take the next one. So there is a concept called Jivan Mukta. A person who is pursuing self-realization, ultimately, he comes to a platform where he is Jivan Mukta. He has no other purpose because his project is complete. What is the goal of human life? To purify one's heart, and his heart is already purified. The purpose of working, what is the purpose of working? The purpose of working is to purify your senses, and this fellow's senses is already purified. So self-realized person has already purified his senses, then why he has to purify his senses? Why should he do that? So that is number one. There is no purpose. So thus he has no reason to perform such a work. That's the first part. Number two, he does not have a need to depend on anyone else. Now what is that? Need to depend on anyone else means he is directly under God. He's directly under God. So one person came and asked me the same question. Now I'll tell you how I replied. He came and asked, we are going in the train together. Tum log dusron ka paise ka khate ho. Open allegation. I said, well, you also do the same thing. Tum bhi dusron ka paise ka khate ho. He said, no, kidhar, kya, nahi. I get my own salary. I said, who gives you money? He said, company. Company ko paise kahan se aate hai? Batao. So he said, other clients, customers, shares. Okay, un logon ko paise kahan se milta hai? He had no clue. He said, ultimately, everything comes from God. Only thing is, you're indirectly under God. We're directly under God. Samajh mein hai? And he was like, he kept quiet rest of the whole journey. Then I gave him a book to read. You read this. You will feel better. I didn't want to humiliate him. But this is fact. So a self-realized person, or a person pursuing the path of self-realization, such a person is directly under God's shelter. So he doesn't have to depend on anyone else. So I'll tell you one Akbar Birbal story. So there was one lady Akbar and Birbal, they had gone to a particular hunting, or they went for some kind of check, review, and look out in the kingdom if there are any issues. So they went in disguised, both of them. So somehow they lost their way, ended up in the woods. They ended up in the woods, and after ending up in the woods, there was a time Birbal, his name was Mahesh Das, and he was a great devotee of Lord Ram. He used to every time do the Ram Nam Jap. Who? Birbal. Birbal was actually not his name. His name was Mahesh Das. Akbar gave him the name Birbal. So Akbar said, "Now we are lost. What are you going to do?" Birbal said, "I'm going to chant. I'm going to chant. My chanting ka time ho gaya. So aapko jo karna aap karo. Mujhe jo karna main karunga." So Akbar went out here and there. Finally, he saw some smoke which was coming out through some chimney. So he went there immediately and said, "I am Akbar." And those people fell flat on the ground. Dandwat pranam. And they said, "Yes, what can we do?" He said, "I am hungry." They said, "Please come inside. We will feed you very nicely." And they fed Akbar very sumptuously. And Akbar, before leaving, he said, "Wait a minute. There is one more person with me, Birbal." They said, "He's also come. Well, please take some more food for him." And as exactly when this happened, Akbar came back. That time Birbal had finished his rounds. Chanting khatam hua, barabar prasad aata hai. So the prasad came and Akbar said, "Please take this for you." Said, "See how wonderfully the Lord has arranged for my prasad." "Hey, wait a minute, Birbal. Ye mail aaya, koi bhagwan vagan nahi. Mail aaya aapke liye." Said, "Thank you, Lord, for making Akbar the Shehenshah. He's called as Jahapana, an instrument in my service. Thank you so much." Now, who can make a king to take something, some foodstuffs, and bring for his subordinate? This is definitely an inspiration of Lord. So, thank you for engaging him. Then Akbar understood. Haan bhai, bilkul. So, self-realized person is like this, dependent on Lord. Yes, and exclusively those who are dedicated, they are also very much dependent. So, this is the second aspect. Another thing what I wanted to mention, I already did mention a little bit, is the purpose of working or doing karma is to purify one's senses. But a person who self-realized is engaging his senses in Krishna's service. So his senses are already purified. Barabar. So it's done. So he doesn't have any reason to work. So heart is purified, senses are purified. Senses have engagement, heart is purified, and also he doesn't have to depend on anyone else. So, such a person doesn't have work. But, now we may say, "Prabhuji, then how did Arjuna get inspired to fight? Yes, sunke. This would have convinced Arjuna further. Right, you are right, Krishna, absolutely. Abhi main turant, right now I'm going to win." But, Lord understands Arjuna's heart. "Arjun, mujhe pata hai, pehle se tu bhagna chahta hai, you want to run away. I'm not going to let you do that. So let's see what Krishna is going to say now." Tasmad asakta satatam karyam karma samachara asakto hi acharan karma paramapnoti purushah.
Therefore, without being attached to the fruits of activities, one should act as a matter of duty. For by working without attachment, one attains the supreme.
See, Arjun, Krishna immediately changed the topic. He understood Arjun's mind is going somewhere else. Immediately. So now what did he say? So he's encouraging Arjuna to become a detached worker. Detached worker means Nishkama Karma Yogi. You work, but don't be attached to result. Same, he's reminding something that he already taught. That platform, you act. And Arjuna is like, "Hey, wait a minute. I think we are already done with this, right? Pehle to samjha chuke the aap. What is this? Now again you are telling work in a detached manner. Kyu karu? Why should I do it?" Next loka.
Karma naiva hi samsiddhim astita jana kadayah loka sangraha me vapi sampashyan kartum arhasi.
Kings such as Janaka attain perfection solely by performance of prescribed duties. Therefore, just for the sake of educating the people in general, you should perform your work.
So Arjuna, in the past, do you know Janak? Said, yes, Janak Maharaj's name comes in the Bhagavatam. He's one of the 12 Mahajanas. Yes, he's also one of them. He's not. Yes. Swayambhu Narada Shambhu Kumara Kapilo Manuhu Prahlada Janaka Bhishmo Balir Vayasaki Vayam. So he's one of the 12 Mahajanas, the 12 propounders of the Bhagavad Dharma or Sanatan Dharma. One of them is Janak. Yes, I've heard his name. He's your pure devotee. And now, just now you said pure devotee. He does not work. He doesn't need to work. He's a self-realized person already. In fact, Vyasdev had to send Sukadeva Goswami to Janak Maharaj to get trained in self-realization. So in one sense, he happened to be the teacher of Sukadeva Goswami, a kind of Shiksha Guru, a teacher of a supplementary subject. Even such a person had to work? Krishna says, yes. Why? Loka Sangraha, in order to teach people by example. To teach others by example. Now, what if everybody becomes a brahmachari? Everybody will think ISKCON matlab brahmachari. No, that's why we have grahasthas also. We have wonderful grahasthas like His Grace Ranchod Charan Prabhu, His Good Wife, and many more. Right? So they are also practicing self-realization in the grahasthashram. So seeing them, he went to the forest county and then he told, yes, yes, please come. Bhagavad Gita is a very practical literature. You also can practice, because most of the time people think Bhagavad Gita practice karne ke liye aisa hi banna padta hai. You have to be like this. So even my Pandit Kaka, who comes for our Marathi classes, he asked me this same question in 2-3 ways. Apan grihastha rahun karu shakto ka? मतलब मैं कर सकता हूँ क्या? मैं फैमिली में रह के कर सकता हूँ क्या? So 2-3 times he asked me the same question, because this is normally everybody's conception. That spirituality, no. ये तो बूढ़े लोगों के लिए number one. When you become too old, the society doesn't need you. That time you can go to Himalayas and practice spirituality. ये ही है. No, this is not correct. This is rejected. You can be a Krishna conscious person or practice spirituality even while being a king. A king. Some of you would have held some position sometimes, like secretary of a society. Aur ek society ko manage karna bhi kitna mushkil hota hai. Really. Ranchod Charan Prabhu manages this group. And when we manage this group also, there are a lot of concerns. He's telling Prabhuji, bahut mushkil hota hai. It's tough to manage even 46 people. How many people he has to manage? Many subjects. But even while being that, one can be Krishna conscious. Not only Janak Maharaj. Let us look at Ambarish Maharaj. Ambarish Maharaj was the king of the whole world. And that time, king means king of the whole world. Pure Earth ka Raja. Bharat Varsh ka Raja. That time Earth was called Bharat Varsh. He was the Raja of the entire Bharat Varsh. And where is his mind? Savai Mana Krishna Padaravindyo. His mind is always with Krishna. That is the art of work. Wherein your mind is absorbed in Krishna and your senses actively do your responsibilities. So such souls, they have duty towards the world but preeti for Krishna. There's a principle of preeti, principle of duty. Preeti is for Krishna and duty is for the world. Hamara opposite hota hai Prabhuji. Ours usually happens the other way around. We have preeti for this world and duty for Krishna. Prabhuji, how many rounds? 4 rounds. Oh my God. Half an hour. Very difficult. But half an hour you watch 3-4 daily soaps every day. Haan, wo to preeti hai na. Ye duty. So this is a shift that we have to make. Something is due to material world, yes, as a matter of duty. And Krishna consciousness, preeti. This is called progressing in yoga. Yes? So it is very, very practical for everyone to do this. Going ahead.
Yad yad acharidi sreshthas tattadeve tarojanah sayat pramanam kurute lokastad anuvartate.
So first of all, before seeing the translation, Now, Krishna told Arjuna, you should set example. Set example. All right, setting example. Why should I set example? Kyu karu? Is there, give me one valid reason why I should set example. That is the answer that Krishna is giving here. Well, why to set example? See, my dear friend.
Whatever action a great man performs, common men follow. And whatever standards he sets, by exemplary acts, all the world pursues.
So, great man like you, Arjuna, you are a hero. You ask an archer who is going to school, what kind of archer you want to be? Mujhe Arjun ki tarah banna hai. And even today, many parents, they give their children name as Arjun, because Arjun is a very good example. So, I want you, Arjuna, to be an emblem of responsibility. I want you to be known for being responsible. A person who adhered to his prescribed duty. Although you think you may not need it, but still, as a matter of inspiring others, be responsible. Because today, if you turn back on your responsibility of fighting this Dharma Yuddha and you go to the forest, tomorrow everybody else, when it comes to take responsibility, they will quit. And they will also walk your path. They will also go to forest. Yes? Why does Modi ji have to take the sweep, no, that jhadu and the sweeping stick and come on the street and sweep? Swachh Bharat Abhyan. Some years back it started. So that everybody is inspired. Oh, PM ji kar rahe, hum bhi karenge. Yes, we'll do it. Inspired. Like so, great souls follows. So I had gone to a youth program. Yes, youth program, youth. Especially the corporate youth, youth who are just entered, passing out of college. So I went, I'd gone there and I saw everyone dadi. Sab log bada bada dadi. And I understood, dadi matlab youth. Youth. So we had two preachings. Dadi preaching and gadi preaching. Gadi matlab grahast. Dadi matlab youth. That's what we used to see at that time. So these fellows with dadi, I asked, what is your inspiration? I see all youths who have come for the my classes with dadi. So one of the persons says, Virat Kohli. Yadyad acharati shreshtas tatta devetaro jana. Usko dekhke hum bhi seekh rahe. We also want to keep big, big beard. Yes. I thought you would say Baba Ramdev. No, youth icon thodi hai. Youth icon is Virat Kohli. And you all want to be like that. So we have dadis. So he is a Shrestha. And whatever he does, everyone follows. Correct? So Arjuna, you are a Shrestha, you have to follow. Now one may ask a question. Hey Krishna, do you do it? Aap karte ho kya? Very, very soon Krishna is going to answer that question also. Because Arjuna naturally asks, "Arey, you are a better example than me. Aap to aur bhi exemplary hone chahiye. Aap karte hain kya? Whether are you an example? And do you do your duties? Let us see what Krishna is saying. Name parthasti kartavyam trishu lokeshu kinchana nana vaptam avaptavyam varta eva cha karmani.
O son of Pritha, there is no work prescribed for me within all the three planetary systems, nor am I in want of anything, nor have I a need to obtain anything, and yet I am engaged in prescribed duties. Mm-hmm.
So this is what Krishna is saying. Arjun, do you know? I don't have any work to do in these three worlds. Spiritual world, maybe. Absolutely not. Because I'm the supreme enjoyer. Work to mere devotees karte hain, barabar. But still, I also perform prescribed duties. That is God. Na tasya karyam karanam cha vidyate, na tat samascha abhidikascha vidyate, parasya shaktir vividaiva shruyate, swabhava ki jnana bala kriya cha. So, jnana, bala, jnana shakti, bala shakti, kriya shakti, like this, Lord has many, many shaktis and energies. Who do the work for Lord? He doesn't need to do any work by himself. There was one person. he had come from Germany and he wanted to know who is God. So one thing he was pakka sure, Bhagwan to India mein milenge. Bahut sare hain. Many, with many hands, many heads. So Bhagwan ko dhoondna, he should go to right place. Go to India. And that was his inner calling also. Inner call? Andar se. Awaaz. Yeah, chalo India chalte. So he came to India and he made a list of all temples and he said this was a bad idea. Bahut sare gali mein mandir hai. So anyway, let me just start. So he started going. He started his research and after some time, he came out with the outcome of research. And the interviewers asked him, so what is your research say? Who's God? He said, Krishna is God. It's like, whoa. Jo pura samasta ved padke, after reading so many Vedas, three times what Brahmaji understood. Yeah, Brahmaji had to undergo the Vedas, study of the Vedic literatures three times to understand who is God, what is bhakti. You did it in a matter of just 3 days. Kaise hai? Kya hua? He said, I went to all the temples and started observing all deities. Some deities, they were holding very dangerous, khatarnak weapons. Astra shastra. Shastra dekhke hum, main to dar gaya. Some of them were meditating. And everywhere I went, somebody or the other was doing something or the other. Kuch to kar rahe the. There is only one person who's beautifully next to his consort standing and playing the flute. He's enjoying. जो एंजॉयर है ना जिसको कोई काम नहीं है वही भगवान है बस दैट्स व्हाट वी सी इन दिस वर्ल्ड आल्सो राइट यू सी द पर्सन हु इज द एपेक्स ऑफ द इंडस्ट्री एनी इंडस्ट्री ही डजंट इवन कम टू वर्क वो कभी भी आता है कभी भी जाता है ऑन द अदर हैंड पीपल अंडर हिम ऑल द डिविजनल मैनेजर्स एडीजीएम्स जनरल मैनेजर दे आर ऑल वर्किंग गेटिंग हैविंग मीटिंग्स एक्सेट्रा दे हैव मीटिंग्स And the people who are managers, supervisors, they are all on the ground. And the operators, they are too constantly laboring and working. Shift mein kaam karte bichare. But what does the big guy do? Apex, wo aata hai. Kahan sign karna hai? Sign kiya, paise liya, pocket mein dala. Bas, chalo. Carry on. He doesn't have any work to do. He just collects the profit, pocket mein dala. Chalo, nikalta hai. Finished. So this is Malik. We observe even in this world. But still, Krishna being such a Malik also performs his prescribed duties. Krishna also gets up early in the morning because his devotees wake him up. Uta dete na, Mangal Arati ke liye. But I'm telling, even when Krishna was there in Dwarka, that time Krishna used to wake up early in the morning, go take bath. After taking his bath, he used to go greet the Brahmanas. After greeting the Brahmanas, he used to give lots of cows in charity. It is that daily Krishna would give 1 crore cows in charity. We cannot comprehend. And this he did for 100 years. Our tiny brain cannot comprehend. Ki kaise Prabhuji 100 into 360 into 1 crore. Kahan se aayi itni sari gaye? That is the Vedic opulence. Yes, Bharat was, even in 17th century, Bharat was a place jahan doodh ki nadiya behti thi. But the foreign invaders came and they slaughtered all our cows. Yes, there were a lot of cows. That was wealth. I'm really sorry. So then, this was a real wealth. So Krishna also performed his duty. He used to come back, he used to offer respects to all the seniors who were there. And after which, Krishna would come and what to do? He has to do sadhana, na? Hum log jaise chanting karte, that is our sadhana. So Krishna says, fine, I'll meditate. But whom? I should meditate on God. Wo to main hi hun. So he used to meditate on himself. There's a picture also of that. So Krishna also is performing his prescribed duties. Next. Okay, what will happen if Krishna doesn't perform his prescribed duties? He's going to say, Yadi hi aham na varteyam jatu karmanya tendritaha mama vartmanu vartante manushyaha partha sarvashaha.
or if I ever fail to engage in carefully performing prescribed duties, O Partha, certainly all men would follow my path.
So Krishna is telling that if I behave in an irresponsible manner, then all of them will also be inspired. Arey Bhagwan ne kiya, hum bhi karenge. Yes, he is not. Where is he doing the duty? So I will also not do. So people watch the leaders. The leaders have to be leading from the front. Yes, they should not lead from the back. Nowadays, what happens? Whenever the warfare is happening, there's a warfare in the battle. So where are the leaders? Where are the lieutenant colonels, the colonels and brigadiers? Okay, well, colonel tak dekhte hain. Lieutenant colonels and colonels are inside the bunkers, who are miles and miles away. They're miles and miles away from a place where there is action going on, warfare action. Yes, it's called the site of action. And they're giving orders. Okay, Delta, Alpha calling Delta, Alpha calling Delta. Copy. Bravo, copy. Okay, fine. Batao, tumhari position kya hai? Dushman humse bas do mila gaye. Jao, attack karo. And where are you? Hiding in the bunker. Wo to theek hai, at least they're in bunkers. Where are others? Where are the brigadiers, the lieutenant generals, major generals? Oh, those people, they are in their head office. Office mein baithte hain. Wo log to bunker mein bhi nahi. Bunker, at least they don't have any facility. Bichare, they are there. And these people sit there. And what about the generals and field marshals? I'm not saying they're irresponsible. I'm not saying that. They have really done a lot. Wo bane wahan pe because they've already undergone this. But I'm just telling you the trend. They are playing golf. It's not irresponsibility. But I'm telling where a leader is supposed to be. If somebody is a general, he's supposed to be right in the front. This was Vedic life. Bhishma Pitama was the general. Yes, he was there in the front. That was Vedic life. Piche koi nahi rehta tha. The leader means in the front. And they send all others and they remain behind. That's not Vedic way of leadership. So Vedic way of leadership is always leading from the front. Because you are not there in the front, well, you will not be able to inspire your people. Because your actions speak so loud that I cannot hear what you say. Speak by actions. That's what people want. That is an inspiring leadership. Next.
Utsi deyuri me lokana kuryam karma chedaham sankarasya cha karta syam upahanyam ima prajaha.
If I did not perform prescribed duties, all these worlds would be put to ruination. I would be the cause of creating unwanted population and I would thereby destroy the peace of all living beings.
So if I do not set a good example to follow, then I'm going to be creating Varna Sankara. Arjuna had this concern in the beginning. Oh Krishna, let me tell you one very, very important factor which you are not considering. That important factor, my dear Krishna, is that if you kill all the male members of the society, because this is the Mahabharat, Mahayuddha, every single province, state, kingdom is taking part in this warfare. And if you happen to kill everybody, then there won't be any male members left. And the women, they may be exploited by other men and thus produce a very unwanted population. They are called Varna Sankara. But Krishna is telling, my dear Arjuna, if you behave irresponsibly, you don't perform your duties, and I don't perform my duties, the leader not performing his duties properly will create Varna Sankara, who will be an irresponsible population. This is how Krishna counters the point of Arjuna. So it's not that by fighting war we are going to create Varna Sankara, the unwanted population. It is by not fighting the war that you are going to create this unwanted population. So Krishna turns around the paradigm. He turns around the understanding. And then Arjuna now is beginning to understand. And somehow, we need to understand that we have to follow Krishna and not imitate Krishna. I wanted to speak a little bit about this. So there was once one boy. This boy came along with his girlfriend to Sri Sri Radha Kunj Bihari Mandir many years back, many years back. And he came and met His Grace Radhesham Prabhu. And he thought that he's making a good argument. So he came and said, that see, Krishna is dancing, doing Rasleela with so many girls. I am going to dance with my girlfriend. What is wrong? So His Grace Radhesham Prabhu said, Krishna, yes, he danced with gopis at the age of 8. But before, at the age of 7, he lifted Govardhan for 7 days and 7 nights continuously. So my dear boy, if you can lift that sofa which is kept there, need not be on one finger, on one hand, and stand there for 7 minutes, then you can go and dance. So that fellow, zoop, gayab ho gaya. He was not visible after that. So the point here is, we are not here to imitate Krishna. What is the difference between imitation and following? Imitation means Krishna did, I will also do. Yes, Krishna stole butter, so I am also going to go and steal. No, Bhagwan ne kiya na, main bhi karunga. Well, then Bhagwan, he lifted Govardhan, you go and do that. Krishna swallowed the forest fire. Forest fire, aap aag dekhoge to aag, aag, you just run away from that place. Krishna swallowed it. Can you do that? Krishna defeated a 1,000 hooded snake called Kaliya. Kaliya Mardhan. Uska pura zeher nikal diya. Yahan pe if I say saap aa gaya, you all will turn off and go away. Saap, oh, finish, gayab. You just saap sunte hum log dar jate. Barabar. So Krishna danced on that. So we cannot imitate Krishna, definitely. But what it means to follow Krishna? To follow means to follow the instructions that Krishna has given in Bhagavad Gita. That is the right way of approaching and following Krishna. Follow what he has spoken. We cannot imitate Krishna. So people come and ask this question. Bhagwan ne, Shri Krishna ne to itni shadi ki, aapne shadi nahi ki. Mujhe Krishna thodi banna hai. I don't want to be Krishna. I am Krishna Das. I am a servant of Krishna. So people think they have logic. But that's not, that shows the poor fund of ignorance. Read the scriptures. That's very important. Right? We have some more time. We'll move ahead. I told we'll pick up pace.
यथा कुर्वन्ति भारत कुर्याद् विद्वांस तथा शक्तस् चिकीर्षुर् लोकसंग्रहम्.
As the ignorant perform their duties with attachment to results, the learned may similarly act, but without attachment, for the sake of leading people on the right path.
Yeah. So there are people in this world who are going to work for results. No problem, they're working, let them go on. But you be different. You work without aspiring for result. But how to practically be without aspiring for result? If you don't want to aspire for result, we have to learn the art of offering the result to Krishna. So unless and until we don't have this particular conception of offering the results to Krishna, till that time we are going to remain attached workers. So the shift that we make from Sakama Karma Yoga to Nishkama Karma Yoga, that shifting of the lever, that happens only when one takes to Krishna consciousness. That is when he can be detached in his work. Otherwise, one remains attached. It is very difficult to keep the lever here. It trips down. One may try, no, I will be selfless in this world. Detached. But that kind of selflessness, detachment also is, there is some selfishness involved. A person may give charity, but at the same time, he will give a phone call to the press. Please come and take some photographs of me doing charity. I am going to conduct Anna Shatra. Yes, please come. Newspaper, sab aage? All newspapers, top newspapers. Please come and click photographs. Take my interview. They want publicity so that they can make more business. Or anyway, government is asking for this... We have the schemes which are introduced in companies that every company has to do some CSR, corporate social responsibility. Otherwise, you cannot do business in India. So as a part of CSR, karna padta hai. Make it no problem. We'll use that as publicity. So everybody has some kind of attachment in this world. So one cannot be detached till the time one comes to Krishna consciousness. So Arjuna is telling you be different. You don't be like others. So you working and they working is different. Correct. Arjuna was fighting the war. Duryodhana also was fighting the war. Apparently, both are doing the same activity, but there is a difference. Duryodhan was fighting for his own selfishness, for his own sense gratification. He was an attached worker. But Arjuna fought the war for the pleasure of Krishna. And he had absolutely no consideration of himself. So this is the platform which we all have to aspire for. Going ahead.
Na buddhi vedam janayet ajnanam karma sanginam joshayet sarva karmani vidvan yukta samacharah.
So no one may ask a question. So I will go and I will tell tomorrow to all my friends, you are all attached workers. I will become detached workers. Ha! Sab log attached ho tum log, moh maya mein ho. So Krishna is giving a warning here.
So as not to disrupt the minds of ignorant men, attached to the fruitive results of prescribed duties, a learned person should not induce them to stop work. Rather, by working in the spirit of devotion, he should engage them in all sorts of activities for the gradual development of Krishna consciousness.
Once a person came to Srila Prabhupada. He said, Swamiji, I'm so and so. I am coming in this particular family lineage. Ye meri parivarik parampara hai. And I am an industrialist. I'm the owner of this industry, that industry, this industry. Prabhupada was, yes, I'm listening. Please go ahead. But I have a lot of tension. What to do, Swamiji? Prabhupada said, very simple. Give all the industries to me. All your tension will be gone. So Prabhupada used to joke when that person was not visible after that. He said, sab tension chala gaya. Thank you so much for giving such an answer by which all my tension went away. Thank you. And he just went. So the point is, a person who is engaged in fruitive work, he should not be told to stop work. Are tu mo maya mein kyun kar rahe? You're doing things, these are all mo maya. This is all maya. Stop maya. And just chant. No, one shouldn't do that. A person is already engaged in fruitive acts. But slowly, slowly, start inducing them to engage their senses in Krishna's service. Like we have the Damodar Mass, the Kartik Mass, where we take a lamp, we show, yes, please call them, come and offer this lamp to Krishna. Bas, that's all. His bhakti has started just by simply offering lamp. Leave that. You just tell him, please come inside and take darshan of Lord. Even taking darshan of Lord is a service to Lord. His bhakti has started. Even if the darshan is closed, let him come to the temple of Lord. He will hear the chanting of the holy names going on. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Just by hearing the chanting, his bhakti will begin. Leave that. Even if he looks at the face of a devotee, he sees the tilak. What is this tilak? This is lotus feet of Krishna. This is Tulasi. His bhakti has started. His or her bhakti has started. So there are so many ways of inducing a person to engage one's senses in service of Krishna. We can employ all those means rather than telling people to stop work. That's what Krishna is telling. Mm-hmm. Okay. So we have 10 more minutes. Let's have question answers. There's a beautiful announcement. I request you all to hear this and go. So Ranchor Sharan Prabhu has said, Hare Krishna, we are starting sessions for the kids group, kids of the age group 5 to 18 years old, coming Sunday onwards. We don't have many, and that's, so this is a great announcement. So there is a great opportunity. And even if your kids have friends, they all are allowed to come. Please do take part in the program for kids. It's an amazing initiative which we are taking from the Bhakti Yoga Club Kharadi. Yes, so please do participate in this. Number two, we don't have any contact numbers of many of them in this group. Please reach us out at the following number. So please, some of you may be shy to share your numbers publicly in this forum. So Ranchor Sharan Prabhu has given his number. I'll again put it to all of you. So please do share your contact to be posted for more such events which are happening in the classes, the regular classes, as well as the events that we are choosing to have. Okay, now we'll take some questions. While performing responsibilities at home and workplace, we tend to lose our goal of having self-realization or self-consciousness. How to balance both? A good question. We need to understand that just as we have responsibilities at home and work, we have responsibilities even towards God. Yes? And it is not just a weekly responsibility. Weekly means that, chalo, aaj Sunday class aa gaye. Bas, thank you very much. So I'm a Sunday devotee. No, we should try to take up some responsibility every day. Yes, daily. One person came to us and said, I regularly come to your temple, Swamiji. Acha? How regularly? Every Janmashtami I come regularly. Bapre. Thank you so much. Bahut upkar kiya aake. Every Janmashtami I come. Wo bhi kyun aate? Hum aate na aapke ghar. I'm a Janmashtami devotee. I'm a Sunday devotee. No, we have to be a regular devotee. Every day. That consistency. Will you water your plant once a week? Is it okay? Sunday ko plant water karengi. Because tabhi time milta hai. No, similarly, the bhakti that we are having in our heart is also called bhakti lata. It's a plant. And plants need nourishment on a daily basis. Until the time we daily nourish the plant is not going to feel. Bahut log bolte, "Pru, main chanting karta hun, karti hun, but I don't see the result." That's because you don't do it daily. Haan, Prabhuji, kaise pata? That's why you're not seeing result. Very clear. Roj karte honge. If you're doing it every day, definitely you will see result. Guarantee. I can write in any bond paper and give you. A person who is chanting continuously for about 6 months will see great results. Great results. It will be a huge paradigm shift in consciousness. So you have to take a daily commitment. The question asked by his... She has privately asked, so I'm not revealing name. So Mataji, you asked the question. We request you to please take a daily commitment of chanting, because ultimately in Kali Yuga, the process for self-realization, God consciousness, is chanting. So take some commitment for chanting. Maybe you can start, if you're not chanting at all, start with one round, two rounds. Anybody, any of you coming to these classes, you're investing 1 hour on every Sunday. I'm sure you'll be able to invest at least 15-20 minutes every day at your homes. So you can, with the 15-20 minutes, you can chant 2-3 rounds. We all watch half an hour TV serials. Take TV serial ke badle zara chanting le lijiye. You can pick up this chanting and half an hour you can chant 4 rounds. Yes. So please increase your spiritual commitment by chanting. Yes, there's Amit Kalia Prabhu. What are the prescribed duties for a person who suffers from certain disability? All right. So, can you please be more specific in case you wish to reveal details? So, otherwise, because I can take this question in 3, 4, 5, 6 ways. Disability, matlab, there may be a person who is unable to speak. How will he chant? No problem. He can take prasad. He can take prasad. He can use his senses to serve Krishna. There's absolutely no problem. Yeah. Bhagavatam is available in Braille script also. Even for the blind. So there is opportunity. Okay, capability to think. No problem. Chanting karo. Anybody who is not even able to think, there's no problem. One can chant. One can chant the holy name. That is not having any problem. He's not able to understand scriptures. I'm not such an intellectual person. Hare Bhagavad Gita, Bhagavatam Prabhuji, Karma Kand, Karma Yog, Sakam Karma Yog, Nishkam Karma Yog, Attached Yogi, Detached Yogi. Becomes too much. No problem. Ultimately, this is all done to bring you to the point of chanting. So chant Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. This can be done by everybody. And purification will be definitely experienced. Okay, any live questions? We have 5 more minutes. Yes, anyone wishes to ask?
Prabhu.
Okay, there was a question. I'm sorry, I muted you by mistake. Yeah, you can ask.
Prabhuji, are there any rituals for mala chanting, like we should take a bath and then only chant, or early morning also without taking a bath and everything, we can chant holy name and then we can do the mala and everything? What are the rituals and what are the best practices we should adopt for chanting?
Yep, स्यात् सर्वत्र सर्वदा एनी टाइम एनी प्लेस कहीं भी शुरू हो जाओ नो प्रॉब्लम दैट इज वन थिंग हाउएवर इफ यू टेक अ बाथ यू फ्रेश देन यू विल हैव अ फ्रेश माइंड टू कॉन्सेंट्रेट दैट्स रिकमेंडेड बट बिकॉज नाउ डेज इट्स क्वाइट कोल्ड एक्सेट्रा सम ऑफ यू मे हैव सम हेल्थ कंसर्न्स सो प्लीज डोंट वरी यू कैन चैंट चैंटिंग डज नॉट हैव एनी रिस्ट्रिक्शंस like that you can chant anywhere
okay.
even without taking bath because I'm not saying the scriptures say namna makari bahuda nija sarva shaktis tatrarpita na niyamena na kala there's absolutely no time place circumstances that can bound chanting yes
thank you so
no thank you Hare Krishna but do chant
Hare Krishna Prabhu ji
Hari bol Swami Prabhu
Yes, Prabhu, I have small doubt. Actually, the chanting and kirtana is having difference getting the things like beneficiaries. Is there any difference between chanting and kirtan?
Chanting and kirtan?
Yeah.
Of course, in one sense, you're glorifying Lord. Your the activity of glorification of Lord is there in both. But when you're doing kirtan, it is congregating with devotees together and doing kirtan loudly. Yeah. So benefit is you are benefiting others also. Everybody, because kirtan is heard by everyone. So others also, they hear, they take part. So you're benefiting. You're also preaching in one sense. When you're doing japa, this actually shows how much taste you have for chanting. Because when you do kirtans, you may be attracted to the tunes, to the dhun, to the dancing. So, and one may think, oh, I have taste for kirtans. No, the real taste for kirtan is when you have taste for chanting the holy name japa. Yes? So, japa is like homework and sankirtan is like classwork. Both are important. But ultimately, one determines one's personal taste, personal development. The other is going to determine the community development. Okay? Okay, so we have reached.
I have one question.
Okay, yes, Mataji.
Sometimes while chanting, it's the chant is very conscious, but sometimes many thoughts come. It becomes mechanical, and it becomes very difficult to concentrate and bring that consciousness. So, how to deal with this kind of things?
Yes, Mataji. It's a very, very common, frequently asked question. Kiroji, I chant. Sometimes the mind is like very nice. Chanting is very good. But sometimes so many thoughts come. What should I do? Very simple. Whenever you come to know, your mind is distracted. Yato yato nischalati manaschanchalam astiram tatastataniyame tad atmanyeva vasham daya. Krishna himself says, when you do the chanting, the mind is going to do its work. And what is why mind's work? To distract you. Because thinking, willing and feeling is the functionality of mind. So mind will definitely try to take you here and there. But you have to do your work to bring back the mind. Wherever the mind has gone, America gaya, vapis lao. Mind is thinking about coronavirus, bring it back. Mind is thinking of India, Indo-China war, bring it back. So bringing it back is our sincerity. So that's what Krishna directly tells in the 6th chapter of Bhagavad Gita. So mind will do its part. Let us do our part. Okay, and how to get the strength to do this? The strength to do this comes from hearing. So when you do nice Shravanam, you hear nice lectures, Bhagavad Gita, Bhagavatam, then you get the inspiration to chant the holy name. You get that determination. So that's where you can prepare. And pray, okay. Pray to Krishna. Let me engage. Bhajahu re mana Shri Nanda Nandana Abhaya Charana Aravindare. Let me engage my mind in simply meditating on your lotus feet. Yes. So Krishna will definitely answer prayers. Last question for today.
Hare Krishna.
Okay. I will take this question and I'll conclude the forum. I'll conclude it and I'll take your question so that those who wish to carry on with their other activities, they can come. Is it okay, Mataji?
Yes, yes, absolutely.
Prabhuji, I chant 6 rounds daily. Very good. Prabhuji, if I didn't do chanting one day, so I can do next day 12 rounds. It becomes a habit. I went to one house. I saw the calendar of one devotee. It was written 2, 2, 3, 5, 6. I said, "Kya kiska phone number itna chota kiska hai? Chiri phone number ni itne mala bache hai mere." My God, disaster. it becomes a habit. So we should at our best not, but because of some reason, say you were sick, really not well, or some days really works takes a toll, then extreme cases, theek hai, acceptable that we do it. Usually those are my counselees. To them I told, Prabhuji, mera chaal mala chhut gaya. I was chanting 16, I did 12, then I forgot I have my 4 rounds were left. So next day I tell them, do it. Then otherwise, you don't punish the mind will take again. अरे चलता है प्रभु जी आज नहीं हुआ कल कर दो आज करे सो कल कर नो प्रॉब्लम व्हाट इज रॉन्ग सो इन ऑर्डर फॉर द माइंड नॉट टू चीट अस इट इज बेस्ट टू लिटिल बिट पनिश द माइंड सो इफ यू आर चैंटिंग 6 राउंड्स यू डोंट डू 6 राउंड्स एवरी डे एटलीस्ट दैट डे यू रियलाइज ओ प्रभु 6 राउंड्स एटलीस्ट डू सम राउंड्स 3 राउंड्स दैट डे एंड देन नेक्स्ट डे यू डू लिटिल मोर सो दैट माइंड इज गेटिंग दैट पनिशमेंट ओके दैट इज माई सजेशन टू यू
Hare Krishna Prabhuji, Dandavat Pranam and Happy Guru Purnima. My question is like, I have two questions. One is, I always have this doubt that among opulences, Krishna said that he is mind. So why is it so difficult to control that mind? Why can't he help us in, at least we are doing some kind of endeavor. Why can't he be merciful and help us in, you know, controlling mind? That was always my question because he's always so merciful, right? So towards his children. So among opulences, he is mind. So why is he so hard on us?
Krishna is not hard on us. First of all, I wish to clarify. It is we who don't want to offer our mind to Krishna. So Krishna tells when he will control the mind for you. Actually, Krishna wants to. Krishna's name is Rishikesh. Rishikesh is one who controls his devotee's mind and senses. But that will happen only when surrenders like Arjuna. So Krishna is willing to do his part. But we are not yet ready to do our part. The problem lies there. So we are not yet ready to give our chariot to Krishna.
So what is that way of surrendering the mind, Prabhuji?
I'll give you a very, very easy homework. Bhagavad Gita 18.66. I think last time Sukanya Mataji also had asked the same question. She is not here. And I had told her, you read this 18th chapter, 66 verse. What is surrender? The purport is very clear. It's very clear. Yeah. So we have to do. So point what I was trying to say is we have to do our part. And Krishna will do his part perfectly. So if we are not getting to control our mind, we are not being controlled in the mind. That goes to show that our surrender is little lacking. So our part is remaining. And number two, we need to understand that what exactly is meant by controlling the mind. Controlling the mind is to engage the mind in Krishna's service. So that's a conscious endeavor. It is not very, it is simple but not easy. Simple but not easy. Which means, whenever the mind goes away, take it back. And fix it on Krishna. This is called sadhana. And eventually you will improve. We will improve. There's something called Albert Einstein's distraction index chart. So Albert Einstein worked once on a particular theory of relativity. He worked for 3 months together. And he didn't even know his wife was every day coming and giving him lunch. He didn't know about that. He was so absorbed. Why? Because he had trained his mind to have zero distractions. Each time he would get distracted, he would make a tally mark. You seen the tally marks? So initially he would get distracted. Then slowly by being conscious of his distraction, he reduce. So Mataji, don't focus on being so, I'll be so focused on Krishna. Rather, today's chanting, I'll be less distracted than yesterday. That's a good way of making improvement. So have a very healthy expectation from yourself. Right? That's
yes,
a more practical way.
Yes,
and Krishna is helping us. He has come in the form of holy name, where we can absorb our mind.
Yes, Prabhuji. I totally agree because 6 months ago, I didn't even knew while chanting, my mind is running somewhere. I didn't even knew. But at least now I know that, yeah, it's going, it's getting distracted. So I have to work on it. At least that part, yeah.
And if you can make your second question a little quick because it's a national youth meeting.
Oh, no, I
not actually, on this ID. Yes.
I actually forgot.
No problem. You can mail me, Mataji. Okay, I'll answer. Thank you all so much. And 38 of you staying back despite extra, which means you're all really sincere students. Sincere students, class hone ke baad bhi rukte. Thank you. Hare Krishna.